starting from Kuvempu to URA, Kalburgi, my father, they are all trenchant critics of Jawaharlal Nehru, of Indira Gandhi, of Rajiv Gandhi. But let me say that none of them ever were physically attacked, let alone death threats. But now death threats has become a common factor in Karnataka. When Kalburgi was killed, one ABBP Bajrangdal guy called Bhuvit Shetty, he sent a tweet saying, anyone who criticizes Hinduism will die a dog's death.
बेंगलुरु में वरिष्ठ पत्रकार गौरी लंकेश की गोली मारकर हत्या कर दी गई।
पत्रकार की हत्या कर दी गई है बेंगलुरु में। गौरी लंकेश वरिष्ठ पत्रकार
की जानी मानी पत्रकार गौरी लंकेश की बीती रात हत्या कर दी गई।
For me, she is always more than a sister. She is my best friend. I could say she is my soulmate. Because more than anybody else, I would talk to her about my creative works, anything like that. I mean, including my daughter, whom she calls. Her Awa means mother itself. She calls me Amma and her Awa.
In Karnataka, in one day, that is the 6th of September, not less than 160 protest demonstrations spontaneously. Karnataka has 177 talukas. Almost every taluka has seen a protest. So, what touched the people, ordinary people? That is the main thing. I think she touched the heart of the people of Karnataka. Because her ideological commitment and emotional conviction to the causes she espoused was so radiant, so radiating, so transparent.
I think that Gauri's murder, which at the personal level is, you know, both shocking and tragic, but I do think it is it goes beyond an attack on an individual, independent-minded journalist, and it is actually an attack on freedom of expression. And I think that is something which. We all need to understand.
One thing that she stood for above everything else was a rational outlook, questioning caste, questioning exclusion, and believing that this country is the country of the questioner, the Shravana. Pluralism and secularism is not a foreign construct. It is a construct deep into the soils of this country, and nobody, no majoritarian fascist can take that away.
And she used to say, if truth is biased, journalism should also be biased. If the truth is one-sided, you should take sides. She never believed in a kind of so-called objective, unpartisan, non-partisan kind of journalism. It cannot exist like that. It will take a stand. So activism was blended into her kind of journalism. So this is Gauri, actually.
She was a voice for the voiceless. So that is what she stood for, I think. And though she's been silenced now, what I feel is, after she's passed away, so many people are like translating on their own and putting it to the social media. Now Nayana publishers have come from Kerala to saying they'll publish it in English. And now the Telugu, they're releasing it in Telugu, the book of which was done by Chandan Goda, a good friend of ours and a journalist as well, our columnist as well. So people are, it's being translated to so many languages. I think many, many Gauris will be born because of this.
We have lost many to such cowards' bullets, but all that have gone, including Gauri, have been brave shining stars, spoken truth to power, gone against the wind. Personally and politically, she stood apart. All of us have a lot to learn from her. If nothing else, the clarity, the grace, the conviction that exclusions and deprivals of all kinds need to unite. And we can't afford to be sectarian under our individual flags. We must dedicate Gauri's death to a renewal of a cohesive resistance. We cannot let her go in vain.
Gauri annu kondaru yakendare avalu badukiddalu. They killed Gauri because she was alive. Because she was alive.